Descubre un nuevo tú. Descubre Lord University.
Bienvenidos a otra programación de Voces Latinas TV Show. Gracias a todos ustedes que están con nosotros aquí cada semana. Y hoy estamos aquí disfrutando de este mes de octubre, de un solecito muy calientito aquí en Toledo, Ohio. Y bueno, hoy le damos la bienvenida a otra amiga de Voces Latinas, Taylor Valderas, la directora de Sofía Quintero, que nos estará hablando hoy sobre un evento muy especial para nuestra comunidad latina. Bienvenida, Taylor.
Thank you for having me.
Great. So, you are here today to talk about Día de los Muertos.
Yes.
But first, can you share with us the history of the Sofía Quintero Center?
Sure. The Sofía Quintero Art and Cultural Center has been around for about 20 years in the community, and we do a lot. One of our major programs is urban gardening, so we have over 50 beds of produce that any community member can come and help us with. We also have bees. So we have over 11 hives that we sell to the local community. So once again, if you're interested in organic homegrown honey from South Toledo, we call it honey from the hood. So we like to really share where it's from. But we also do cultural cooking, cardio drumming, salsa dancing classes, an art gallery, art program. So we're really involved in a couple things.
Well, I am allergic to bees, but I would be interested in the honey.
That I can do.
That's great. So how long have you been with the Sofía Quintero Center?
I have been the director just for this first year, but I've been involved since I was just a young girl. So I've always volunteered or attended the events, so I'm very familiar with it, but on staff, just new.
That's wonderful. Well, I know I love to attend the Día de los Muertos. Mm-hmm. Can you share the different events that you'll have this year?
Sure. Día de los Muertos is one of our major fundraisers that we do. And the holiday itself, it's very colorful. It's very joyous. It's a celebration of life. It's not anything kind of, you know, down or anything like that. So we have a couple things. We set up altars or allow community members to set up altars for their loved ones that have passed. And we celebrate it with a big dinner November 4th. So we have a dinner, music, food, altars, art that we all kind of combine into that night just to kind of have a big celebration of life.
That's wonderful. Well, no se lo pueden perder. Este año, el Día de los Muertos, tiene muchas diferentes eventos mm-hmm. o tiene diferentes cosas que van a hacer. I know you share with me that you'll be closing down the street.
Yes. So we're kind of always adding to the event to kind of try to top it off from the year before. So we're going to be setting up an event tent that will decorate kind of with the Día de los Muertos theme. And it's all to kind of tie in together between the dinner and the altars. So that way attendees can kind of walk through and kind of feel the holiday and experience what, you know, you would if you were celebrating it elsewhere.
Bueno, este evento definitivamente nos ayuda a levantar o empezar todos estos días festivos. Y este año van a tener diferentes cosas. Actually, I have a question. Mm-hmm. Will it be available for children to come? I mean, that tent that you have available on the street?
I mean, the tent's just for decoration is part of the event. If you do have children that you'd like to get involved, what we do is 2 weeks after the main fundraiser, we open our art gallery and we keep the altars up. And we actually have school groups that will come through and we'll teach them about the holiday and kind of, you know, what it's about and maybe talk to them about that. So if you have any children or you yourself want to see the altars, please feel free to come by about 2 weeks afterwards. We're more than welcome to open the doors for you.
That's wonderful. Well, I know this event, it is entrenched in the Catholic religion. Mm-hmm. I love that you said it's a happy celebration.
Yes.
I know a lot of people that are not aware of the event or don't understand it, believe to be a dark
right.
event.
Yeah, it's absolutely not. It's believe that for one evening, those that have disease, they say the gates open where they can cross over and visit us. So there's dinner and music, and even in Mexico at their graves, it's celebration and color and laughter and telling stories and things like that. So we really try to educate the community because, you know, if you translate Day of the Dead, if you don't truly understand it, you may not, you know, quite get that. So yes, it's all joy and just happy and celebrating the life of that person.
So how will our viewerships buy the tickets? Can you share with them about the specifics about it, mm-hmm. the times that it begins and then it ends?
Absolutely. So again, it's Saturday, November 4th. Tickets are $50 a person, and that includes your meal and the whole celebration. Please contact us. You can visit our website, squawk.org, or our Facebook, the Sofia Quintero Art and Cultural Center, and get a hold of us. If you want to see the altars about 2 weeks after, just come on over. We're always welcome to open our doors. Just kind of come on over and we'll be happy to show you around.
Taylor, congratulations on being the director.
Thank you.
You do a great job.
Thank you very much.
You have to make sure you come and visit us more often since you're just across the
street. I will take you up on that. It's good advertising and marketing, so I will.
Thank you once again. Bueno, gracias por estar aquí con nosotros. Vamos a tener toda la información sobre este evento en nuestra pantalla para todos ustedes que estén interesados en atender esta gran noche de Día de los Muertos, muy simbólico para nuestra comunidad latina. Marisol Ibarra, quédense aquí y disfruten de nuestros latinos videos calientes.